In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to add Tailwind CSS to a Hugo project. To follow along, you will need to have Hugo and Node.js installed. I will be using VS Code, but any text editor will do. In a new terminal window, let's navigate into the directory where our projects are stored. In my case, this would be the Sites folder. It may be different for you. Next, let's create a new Hugo project called Hugo Tails. You can probably come up with a more creative name than that for your site. We can see here that the project has been successfully created, so we can move on and create a new theme. Let's navigate into our project directory and generate a new theme using the Hugo New Theme command. Once the theme has been created, we have to let our Hugo config file know that we would like to use this new theme. We will be adding Tailwind to this project as a PostCSS plugin. In order to achieve this, we must first initialize npm in our project directory. Since this is a demo, we can skip the setup wizard by passing in the --yes flag to the npm init command. Now that we have a default package.json file to work with, we can move on to installing the necessary dev dependencies. You can check the description box for a brief explanation of what each dependency does. With the dependencies installed, we can create a CSS folder for our theme. This CSS folder will contain a PostCSS config file, a Tailwind config file, and a style sheet for our styles. Let's make sure our project is actually open in VS Code. Now we can begin fleshing out our PostCSS configuration. We will start off by storing the path to our theme in a constant. Our plugins will be held in a little array. We will require the PostCSS import plugin before anything else. We do this to ensure that all import rules from our CSS are the first things to be processed. Now every plugin that comes afterwards will behave as if they're just working on a single style sheet instead of multiple style sheets. Our Tailwind config file will mostly consist of boilerplate stuff. You can visit the Tailwind documentation to see all the ways you can extend and customize values for your unique designs. That's all the configuration we need for now. Let's go ahead and import some base Tailwind styles into the style sheet we created earlier. Before we can start using Tailwind classes, we need to import our style sheet within the head partial that Hugo gave us when we generated our theme. In order to process our SAS file with Hugo pipes, we must first retrieve it as a resource using the resources.get method. Because the browser won't be able to do anything useful with the SAS file, we will need to convert it to CSS. We can then pipe the result of that conversion to PostCSS. Here we must also pass in the path to our PostCSS config. Hugo supports PostCSS out of the box, so this will just work without further configuration. We can serve different versions of our CSS file depending on the environment. If we are working locally, the current state of our CSS will be sufficient. If we're in production, however, we'd like to serve a minified fingerprinted version of our style sheet instead. We can easily do this using Hugo pipes. Now that all the setup is complete, we can add a little header to see if everything is working as intended. We'll build our site using the Hugo command, and we can start the server by running Hugo server. If we navigate to localhost port 1313 in a browser, we can see our little header. Now we can finally take our newly implemented Tailwind classes for a spin. Let's update the header to take the full width of the browser window. We'll also give it a light red background color and centralize our text. We can go back to the browser to see the changes. And there you have it. In this tutorial, we saw how we can add Tailwind CSS to a Hugo project. I hope you found this video useful. Thank you for watching.